Robert Dougal, a young radio reporter on board a British destroyer in a North Atlantic convoy in 1941.
We're now mixed up in the first attack on a convoy which has been actually recorded at sea. Terry Carpenter is on our port quarter, not much more than 500 feet up, I should say, a tracer bullet bursting all around him. There go his bombs, and now they're dropping down over the convoy. Wait a minute, he's missed. Columns of water spouting up, but he's missed. There's just a faint smell of gunpowder and smoke drifting across the water.
By 1943, 3,000 ships have been lost to air and submarine attacks in the battle to keep open Britain's Atlantic lifeline.
This is London Calling. Something going on in Britain now. Salvage drives are sweeping the country, for salvage is playing a great part in the manufacture of armaments. Nothing is being wasted anywhere.
British civilians are being told not to waste anything. Florence Speed in Streatham finds the salvage drives, saving schemes, and hardships on the home front ever more demanding.
Sites are being cleared.
Ethel took down the blackout this morning to find workmen removing the iron railings around the front garden.
That is the beginning of a story of determination that can end on the battlefields of Russia.
They were using a blow lamp, which sent out thousands of sparks. It was a pretty sight, even though the effect was like an incendiary.
Lord Beaverbrook's own London house is giving up its iron railing.
Beaverbrook asked for pots and pans and even kettles.
Up and down the country, it's the same story.
All of us except Bertha have agreed to part with our hot water bottles and are waiting to see if Nora will part with any of her kitchen utensils.
My true love was true. I, of course, replied something here.
The pig and bone bins at the end of the road had overspilled this morning. 12 slices of bread lay about the pavement. Wicked waste, even in peacetime.
All who love are blind.
But while transport of food means the loss of many merchant seamen's lives, it's disgraceful.
But in the summer of 1943, improvements in Allied intelligence and the extended range of air cover begin to turn the tide in the Battle of the Atlantic.
The British, American, and Canadian forces of the sea and air hurled their strength upon the U-boat. It ended in the total defeat of the U-boat attack. Staggered by these deadly losses, the U-boats have recoiled to lick their wounds and mourn their dead. Now, we have had in June the best month from every point of view we have ever known in the whole 46 months of the war.
In the battle for the skies of Europe, the pressure on the supply of fighter pilots is so great that hundreds of Britain's trainee flyers have to travel to the United States to win their wings. From the Spartan School of Aviation in Tulsa, Oklahoma, David Green writes to his mother in Middlesex.
The people of Tulsa have given us a great time. Coca-Cola seems to be the national beverage. It's cold, with the texture of fizzy lemonade, dark in colour. The medical officer told us to drink lots of it. I now have 11 hours flying to my credit. I hope to solo tomorrow. I can do spins and rolls, so I'm not doing too badly.
After getting his wings, David Green flies fighters in the Mediterranean throughout the rest of the war. Over 30,000 planes see service during the war with RAF Fighter Command. Neville Duke from Tunbridge wins a DSO, DFC, and two bars, flying Spitfires in the Mediterranean. He becomes one of the RAF's most decorated pilots.
I love flying. 1 minute nipping along the deck at 0 feet, and then with just a gentle pull on the stick, soaring up and up. You feel the immense power at your fingertips, part of this fine machine built by a genius. The Spitfire is too beautiful to be a fighting machine. But then, what better weapon of war could you want?
In the autumn of 1942, Air Vice Marshal Keith Park sends a message of congratulation to the Spitfire pilots on Malta, commending their role in the heroic defense of the island.
Your magnificent fighting in the last 5 days is being watched not only by the RAF, but also by our Russian allies.